Hello, everyone, and welcome back. We are here in our New York studio on the outskirts of the UN General Assembly, covering live a big moment in the global development calendar, and that is when the world's leaders gather normally in person this year in this kind of strange hybrid here in New York. And we've been covering it and bringing it all to you all day long. If you've just joined us, you may not know, I'm the President Editor-in-Chief of Devex. I'm Raj Kumar, and I'm joined by my colleague, Teresa Welsh, who is a senior reporter here at Devex, covering all things food and many other topics around the world. How's the day been going for you?
Good. It's such a pleasure to be here in person.
Isn't it nice?
Feels like a novelty. It's such a pleasure to do in-person interviews, get to interact with people. It's really fantastic.
Yeah, and it does feel a bit like a privilege knowing how many people couldn't make the trip to New York and how tough it is to be here. But it's great to be here.
It is.
So what have you been picking up in our coverage today? You've had a couple of interesting sessions, especially on the Food Systems Summit, which is coming up. What have you heard?
Yeah, so we've been talking a lot about the Food Systems Summit the past couple of months in DevEx, and had a couple of sessions this morning. And what's really stood out to me so far this week is the connections people are drawing between the Food Systems Summit that we'll see on Thursday and COP that we'll see later this year, and really making that intersection of food systems, agriculture issues tied to climate, and lots of folks calling for that to be something that we just have to be doing. You can't solve one without the other.
Yeah, I mean, this was kind of the reason for the Sustainable Development Goals to be created in the first place, right? The idea that all of these issues are ultimately connected, and we're really seeing it at a moment like this where we're talking climate, pandemic, food, all at the top of the General Assembly agenda this week.
Exactly. And the purpose of the Food Systems Summit was to break down those silos and bring together people from all of these sectors. So I've been having conversations with folks that have been involved with that. I was chatting with one of the Action Track leads this morning and asking, you know, where does this go from here? Mm-hmm. You have this nice UN moment on Thursday, but what comes out of this? Yeah. What are we going to see? How are you going to carry this forward? And, you know, he didn't say, oh, we might, you know, keep talking or whatever. He said, we will. We have committed to carrying this work forward. We understand this is what has to be done.
Right. The criticism, if there is one, of this annual gathering is it's a talk shop. You know, people come and they make a big speech, but nothing really comes of it. And hopefully, I don't think it's definitely the case yet, but hopefully there's enough accountability now and the crises are big enough that there are some actual commitments. My conversation this morning with the UN climate chief, Patricia Espinosa, she said things are actually moving. She feels very optimistic. You know, she feels like there's some ground being laid for actual tangible action at the COP that's coming up in Glasgow.
Yeah, I think that's really key with the Food Systems Summit too, is okay, where is this going? And more importantly, who's gonna be watching? Who's gonna be making sure that folks are being held accountable? So that's definitely something I will be watching, particularly with my new newsletter, DevEx Dish. We'll be focusing on that in the coming months and, you know, really talking about how all these issues are coming together, but, you know, what progress is being made, how we're determining what equals progress, who's measuring that?
Yeah, and getting behind kind of the official pronouncements, the press releases, to what is that inside story, which is exactly the reason it's named DevEx Dish.
Exactly. And we went through many names when we were trying to put together this newsletter, and we're really pleased with what we came up with. So I hope folks will subscribe to that and, you know, stay tuned to all of our DevEx coverage.
If you want the dish, if you want
exactly.
the inside scoop.
I got the dish.
Let me just say a word as we close about what you have to look forward to the rest of this week. There's so much that we're covering. You know, our coverage today hasn't actually ended. This is the end of this session. But at 12 o'clock Eastern time, we have a conversation with the U.S. Global Malaria Coordinator, Raj Punjabi. And that's produced in partnership with IntraHealth. And then after that, at 1 p.m., we have another ecosystem event. And that's on harnessing geospatial data to achieve SDG 2, Zero Hunger. And that's in partnership with ESRI. So stay tuned for both of those if those are topics of interest to you, and I'm sure they are knowing the DevEx audience. There are going to be links in the chat right now if you want to follow along. We do have French and Spanish translation on Zoom. Again, for people who are just joining, might not be aware of that. I want to make sure you know. Tomorrow, there's some exciting things. Achim Steiner, who is, of course, the head of UNDP, is going to be in conversation with our colleague, Advas Aldinger. There are a number of interesting panels on decolonizing aid and development, on leveraging digital health technology. There's a lot going on. I'm not going to take you through all of it. There's a full agenda you can find on the site. But if you are just joining or just tuning in, you're going to want to tune in tomorrow because there's much more of what you've experienced today. I think it's been pretty fun to do this. It's a mix of, you know, being in the studio with some people, being virtual with others. But I feel like we're starting to get the real story out to our community around the world.
Yeah, exactly. And it's been, you know, it's been nice to be able to bring the folks that aren't able to be here to us, albeit virtually as well.
Yeah. And as I said at the opening, these are the most important issues in the world. They deserve more coverage. And this event has actually grown into one, the General Assembly, where real things happen. So we think it's important to be here, and we're very honored and privileged to get to bring these stories to all of you. Thanks for being a part of the day today. Stay tuned, and we'll see you all soon.